Hello everybody, Golden Tales Geek here. Welcome to another exciting episode of Quest of Dungeons. In the last episode, we finished the Rackham Mansion on my first try. I'm still rather proud of that. In this episode, we're going to check out something else I unlocked after beating it. Let me just take Assassin here. And now, we've unlocked a custom game, which we can select parameters of how big the dungeon floors we want to be, how many floors, up to 10 we want to do, and what difficulty we want to do. However, we're going to tackle the Rothar Mansion now. And this is hard. I am not going to lie. I mean, I've been trying to get through it countless times on my Switch copy of the game, and I don't even know how many floors there are. I don't know how many bosses there are. I just know it's hard as hell, and we're gonna try it. It's a dark breeze up there. It's a dark night with a gentle breeze in the air. You finally reach the ruins of the old Rothar Mansion. But who knows what secrets and horrors lie inside? And will you survive? Anyway. Yes, I genuinely don't know what I'm in for this, full on for this. I really don't. I've only made it to about the second floor in my Switch copy, so yeah, I'm practically flying blind, honestly. And a doom key right off the bat on the top door, that's a good omen. And that should give you an example of why right there, is that these zombies, oh my lord, these zombies. They take multiple hits, even on the easiest difficulty. I don't know, there should be an achievement in this game for going through this the Rothar Mansion on Hell difficulty. But I doubt there will be. And we found the shopkeep, so that's a plus. And I'm lucky that zombie landed on those spikes, because I kind of needed that. Alright, let's see here. There we go, so far so good. Gotta make sure that the... Okay. And there's a square key door over there, but... Ah, well. And this episode, I'm gonna basically be trying to get through the first floor. So hopefully we'll get through here intact. And if I die, then I'll try again. But... You know, the Rothar Mansion can be downright ruthless sometimes if you're not careful, so I'm going to try to be really careful here. And we're coming up on a level up, so that's a plus. In fact, probably the next zombie I kill. Yep. How about that? I'm getting really lucky with how the enemies are coming after me here. There we go. Awesome. Slow and steady wins the race, folks. Who disturbs my slumber? It's amazing you can formulate words with your rotting throat or something, zombie boy. Okay. Keep going here. Nope. Nothing there. That's a waste of a room if I ever saw one. Also, another thing that doesn't help is that sometimes you can encounter bosses. Like there was one time I would started up a run of the Rothar Mansion on my Switch copy. And, okay, you know what? Equip that. Why not? Even though minus resistance. But, what was I going to say? Oh, yeah. And, the first room I went into was a boss. And I tried to kill it. Because I was stupid like that, and I used up all my potions and all the healing items that I had in my inventory. Wound up killing him, but then an ordinary enemy ended up killing me because I was so low on health because of the fact that I was so weakened and I was out of healing items. It also kind of makes me thankful that every few steps you replenish a little bit of your health, because otherwise I probably would have been really... I've seen better looking rocks. Okay. And we got an enemy of some sort. Lovely. And he's in the center position of the map, so let's kind of avoid the center position of the map for a while, because the enemies there can be a pain in the ass. The pallet swap enemies can be a pain in the ass. Let's see here. Doing well so far, but regardless. There we go. Oh, great. Alright. Looks like we gotta head for back around the corner here. I love the music, this music. It just lends so much atmosphere. Also, if you listen carefully, you can hear a bit of the drums from the jazzy swing number of Whenever You Meet Your Shop, the Shopkeep. So it's kind of a nice little bit of instrumentation there. Anyway. Oh, trying to sneak up on me, eh? Okay. Well, good luck with that. Gold do I have? Not a lot. Alright. Here, nasties. There we go. Kill that guy. Ah, well. On the plus side, at least I'm dealing with these guys pretty handedly, so. Oh, there's ghosts on this floor, too. Oh, shit. Really? Oh, crap. There we go. Ah, damn it. Yep. Alright, let's start up a new run. Rothar Mansion, let's go. There we go. But yeah, this is just to demonstrate to you that no matter how careful you are, Rothar Mansion can be very ruthless. So. There we go, perfect. Awesome. If I do somehow manage to get through the first floor in this episode, I'm going to wrap things up. And if not, well, we had a good run, and I'm not going to wrap up the Let's Play. I'm actually going to probably show off. I actually just recently finished a run of the Umfar Mansion as the swordsman guy, so maybe I'll do that as my next bit. But I might do two floors per episode, just so you guys aren't bored as hell, you know? Anyway. There we go. Level up. Awesome. Gotta keep my wits about me here. I was doing really well on whittling down that enemy's HP, though. I was trying to heal up, and it just, like, that critical hit just sideswiped me. It was awful. I'm still kind of impressed with myself that I managed to get through the Rothar Mansion on my first try, honestly, because I was genuinely thinking that I was going to do that. Especially considering I got sideswiped by that vampire. Oh, I need a rusty key. Okay, there we go. Okay, let's continue onward. Trying to sneak up on me there. Oh, Lord. Didn't even get to that, meet that pallet swap enemy in the last run. Probably that's for the best, actually. Whoa, critical hit. There we go. Go, awesome. Here we go, awesome. You know what? Let's head down to the corner here and go through here real quick. It almost looks like we're navigating some kind of weird graveyard or prison hybrid thing. I don't know. It's kind of off-putting, honestly. It kind of put me off when I first tried the Rothar Mansion on my Switch copy of the game. awesome. So good. There we go, level 3. So many zombies around here, though. Where does this go? Ooh, right over here. Okay, not too bad. I've been trying to embrace the using the teleporters a bit more lately, just to kind of feel things out here. Oh, great. We got another enemy in the center of the map. That's something else that we gotta keep our wits about us for. Alright. Here goes something. Oh, there's a shopkeep. Awesome. We'll come back for you later. Oh, I found a square key and it's in this run, and yet I can't go back to my other run. Oh, great. We got an enemy. Hold on. Let me reread that. Oh, great. It's another palette swap enemy, and he's in the north position of the map. That's comforting. But at least I found the shopkeep, so that's a blessing, I guess. Keep her going. There we go. Ooh! This is our first instance of something. That is a hero ghost. And he's like the ghost of a previous hero that died in the dungeon. And you actually can get an achievement for it's the first instance of me showing this off in the video, so that's kind of... And it's, but yeah, he has, what was I gonna say? Shit. Save that for later. That little thing for later. But, if you defeat 3 of them, you can actually get an achievement. So that's kind of nice. It's a really rare phenomenon, though. I don't know exactly the nature of what causes this. But it's still a nice little, it's a nice little detail, I like that, where you can basically kill the ghost of your previous character that you were playing as, and loot his stuff, basically. Which comes in handy. In fact, since my inventory's getting kind of full, I think I better sell off a lot of this crap. I'm gonna here. Let's see, sell, use. All these fishes. There we go. Good riddance. I'm not gonna buy the keys, but I am gonna buy these because I need defense. So equip you. There we go. A little more defense. 89 gold though. Lovely. Let's check the map here while we're in some of the funky tune here. Yeah, I think I know where to go next. Knock on wood. Oh, man. I just gotta really keep my wits around me here. Oh, no! Oh, no. Heal. No! Ah! Yeah, pretty much not again, yeah. Alright. I'm gonna try this again. I'm gonna try this one last time, and then if I die again, I'm calling it an episode. So let's keep going. Let's go. There we go. Okay. Like I said, Rothar is ruthless. Oh, awesome. There we go. Awesome. Brilliant. There we go. Awesome. Alright, let's see. I mean, this is even... I'm playing this on the easiest difficulty, folks. And I'm having... And I died twice. So, yeah, that if that doesn't fully illustrate to you how brutal this is, I don't know what to tell you. I almost consider this like expert mode, but not, but I don't know. I honestly don't know what the developers were thinking when they made this. I was considering tweeting them, asking them, why'd you make Rothar Mansion so brutal? But I just couldn't do it. Oh, geez. I better heal here, because I'm running low on health. Die. There. So much dodging. God. Oh, God. And a few doors that require keys I don't have right off the bat. If I encounter another hero ghost, though, that would be awesome, because I could actually unlock that door, because I actually had a light key, and I think I had a square key, so. But I doubt very seriously I'm going to use it. Oh, hang on. Something happened here. Oh. Well, hang on a sec. I'm gonna save and exit and come back. Okay, we're back. Sorry about that. I don't know what happened. It was weird. Like, the game kind of glitched and everything. I don't know. It was really strange. And I didn't mean to consume my HP tube now. I'm down to 2, but... Ah, well, shit happens. But, yeah, anyway, let's continue onward with, killing off these zombies as best we can. Provided I don't become dinner for them. Okay. Go, so far so good. Oh, hello. We got a couple bows here. Oh, we built that one. There we go. Awesome. Well, at least we got some goodies. There we go, snipe view. Awesome, brilliant. Okay, nothing there. Awesome. There we go. Dang, these enemies are really clever, I swear. Let's see here. Got an enemy in the northwest position of the map I gotta look out for, and I also have an iron pendant in the east position of the map. Well, actually, even though I was just already in the east part, let's kinda take a look. Let's see here. Nothing there. I'm looking at the east, what I think is the eastern part of the map here, but I really don't know. Unless it's up here, maybe. I don't know. Nope. Nothing. Okay, fair enough. Let's continue onward then. Onwards and upwards. Thank you. I love that it's called the boots. Ooh, extra gold and a block chance. Okay, we'll take that. God, a lot of stuff here. Hope I find a shopkeep soon. I want to sell off all this crap. Right, I'm gonna get killed first, but still. Another door that requires a rusty key. Lovely. No shopkeep here. Up some of this food. Oh. Okay, that egg refilled my health pretty much. Awesome. Maybe I'll keep some of the food around in my inventory then instead of just selling it off like I tend to do. Oh, secret stash. There's actually an achievement you can get in the game for finding 50 of those. I don't know how many I've gotten at this point. And this is across all runs, by the way, so. I don't know why I'm being a little, there was a little bit of a slowdown there for a minute, but anyway, you know. There we go, awesome. There we go, awesome. Far so good. God, so many zombies. Of course, I get a key, and it's a doom key, which I don't need. Thanks for that, game. Really appreciate it. Well done, you. Do you want me to give you a doggy biscuit as a reward? I mean, seriously. Oh, hello. Alright, let's. Oh well. Nice effort, but you died. Thanks, game. We haven't even seen my favorite dying message yet. But with that, I think we're gonna call it for today. And like I said, Rothar is ruthless. In the next episode, I think I'm gonna start a whole new run on the Omphar Mansion and go through the first two floors, and we're gonna do the swordsman class. Show you a different kind of gameplay style. So you're not sniping from a distance, you know? I mean, those are the two classes I've kind of grown on. The shaman and the warzard ones I haven't really tried yet. Hell, I haven't even tried the necrodancer one yet, but I hear it's pretty good. But, yeah. Anyway. Oh, and I'll put a link in the video description so you can get the game on Steam. It's $5. It's probably on sale right now because of the whole coronavirus thing. Who knows? But regardless, it's there for the taking if you want it. Until the next one, this has been Golden Tales Geek. Thanks for watching. Keep on gaming. And be awesome to one another. Take care, everybody. Bye.